So American Optical sunglasses, we know they've gone through and updated some things. They're making some changes to the production. They have brought back the Saratoga. They've redesigned or at least updated the tooling, machining, and the processes for the General and the original Pilot. We've talked about the Saratoga. I'll link that one up here. Today, let's dive in and take a look at the original Pilot. First, before we get to those beauties, if you haven't already, you're new to the channel, like and subscribe and ring the bell so you can keep up with the latest and the coolest. Now, let's dive in and take a look at the new Pilot. So this is what you actually came here for, to see the new versions of the American Optical Original Pilot sunglasses. Now they do make this in the standard hockey temple, which I don't have here, but that's going to be your normal where it just bends down behind the ears. Super simple, super classic. It's out there, it's everywhere. You know what they look like. The bayonets, only a few companies make. Primarily Randolph and American Optical. Now, if you want to get my thoughts on how these two compare, I have another video on that. We'll link that card up. I'll put it down in the description below as well, so you can check out that head-to-head. As far as this, I do want to focus on just the American Optical Pilot today. This is a classic one. It's been around a long time. I don't believe it's ever actually been military use, but it has been used as a replacement in a handful of movies. So, we all have our purposes, right? So as far as this, it is made in three different sizes. I actually have here the two on the far end of the spectrum. So this is the smaller 52, and this is the larger 55. And they do fit pretty well true to size, because you have a small, a medium, which we don't have here, and then the large, which is this guy, and it deserves a little pat on the head because it's so cute and sweet. And I've got, of course, the gold, and the green is the one that's out of stock because it's the most popular, the most classic, and the original true to form colors. We do have here the green non-polarized lens. I tend to prefer that in these because it has that more original AO sage green coloration and look. It's going to give a little bit better color than what the actual polarized version does, because it retains more of that true green classic look. Then this is the smaller in the silver. So we've got the matte gunmetal and then just the shiny silver finish. Of course, the other is the yellow gold. It's classic. We all know what it looks like. I just happen to not have one right now because that was the first one I sold and they're on back order. And yeah, I won't blabber on too much about that. Overall finish on these is really, really good. Now, I will say, and I do mention this in my other video, Randolph is just a tick better still. These are still incredibly well made. Either one's going to last you a lifetime, honestly. The way they're built, they're both spectacular. And of course, they still use the glass lenses largely in the American Optical frames, but now they do offer the choice of nylon lenses if you prefer something a little bit lighter weight. So as far as overall actual fit and feel of these guys, again, I do stick with the glass lenses. As you guys know, if you've been here for long, I far prefer the absolute crisp of glass in terms of optics. Now, the nylon's not bad, and it does save you a ton on weight, but you know, when it comes to maximum clarity, glass is always going to be there. It tends to be a little bit more durable as well when it comes to scratch resistance. It's a little worse when it comes to fogging. Even with my mask, I can't even see anymore. Oh, but anyway, so this is the large, and you can see on me, it is a pretty good bit bigger than a really nice fit. Still not too bad. It could work for an oversized look. The petite is rather small on my face, and I just can't go for it. I'm also not a huge fan of silver. That's just me. Now, the medium and gold, of course, fits right in between the two. I don't have it. Now, they do make these in all the different colors, and one thing I love in particular is some of these have a different lens choice. So, like this one, I believe, always comes with the green in that matte gunmetal. The silver, you can get the gray or the brown, I want to say. I mean, I really should have looked before I did this. But that one is still really good the way it is. The gold is the green. Maybe that's the one with different lens choices. Anyways, so the really nice thing here is I mentioned there's no matter which way you go, these are built to last a lifetime. You've got the solid monoblock hinge on either side. And what that amounts to, the eye wire screw and the temple screw are made into one solid continuous block, as the name would imply, being a monoblock. And you can see it's a nice finish, not anything crazy as far as the solder joints, all nice and clean. Now they have updated and they've changed to the logo just a little bit. So you can see that difference if you're looking specifically for the new version. They have updated that logo on the lens and on the temple. I do love how they've gone in and integrated that into the temple. It's a really nice look to me, as well as you do have that little bit of a metal and plastic combination on the nose pads. Overall, these provide a really nice snug fit, good feel. With those bayonet temples, they're going to fit really nice to the head and super easy to wear, you know, with a helmet or any sort of headgear, anything like that. And that was kind of the original purpose here. Something that worked well for pilots to fit under their headgear and still allow them to function and work and see what they're doing. I really love the shape of these. It's one that works on a lot of different faces. It's gonna be easy to wear. You know, there's, because of the structure they add into this with a little bit of softness and some nice angles, it's just a really good universal shape. There's not a lot of people that you're gonna put that on and just, oh God, this is awful, I can't wear this. Pretty much anybody can put that on and it's gonna look okay at the absolute worst, and it's gonna be amazing at the absolute best. Now, that is all I'm gonna bore you with on the AO General Pilot today. Next time, we will talk about the General. But we'll talk about some other things before that, because that's two frame reviews back to back. Anyways, if this helped you out, let me know, and definitely let me know your thoughts on the new version of the AO Original Pilot, as I have heard a lot of people prefer it to the old one, which is interesting because AO is kind of that classic company and that is their thing, and I gotta stop touching my mask. I will catch you guys next time. Let me know what you thought of this video down in the comments. Check out some of the links there for some cool gear as well, because why not? We gotta make it fun around here, right? I'll catch you next time.